reading Excel files in C# the easy and free way.
I can't do this anymore, man. My head's about to explode.
Reading Excel files should be easy, right? I just felt really frustrated after reading code blocks online.
And every time I drive down the road, I want to jerk the wheel into a goddamn bridge embankment.
You will learn how to read from a single worksheet, multiple worksheets, and a password protected file. Let's create a new project in Visual Studio. It'll be the unit test framework project, and we'll call the project Excel Tests. Next up, let's install the NuGet package Excel Mapper. Rather than using the Microsoft Interop Excel NuGet package, which is a verbose package and complicated, this one is much easier and more concise to work with. Great, let's read our first worksheet. It's a list of names, and we will create a new person C# class and match each of the properties column headers within Excel to our C# class, that being first name, last name, date, and email. Let's create our first unit test. We'll call it I can read 100 rows from Excel sheet, because the Excel sheet contains 100 rows. So that's what we will be expecting. To write that, we'll write assert r equal 100 and compare that to a variable count. Now let's make some magic happen using our Excel Mapper library. Very simple, we need to pass it a file name, and we'll call the method fetch and fetch it to our person object. My file name is in my temp directory. It's called list of people.xlsx. And that's it, we've got a list of people. Let's test this. So we'll assign count and count the number of objects we're getting back. Good practice is to fail the unit test the first time by changing the expected number to 101 and closing the existing worksheet here. Yep, it's failed. Let's change it to 100, run it again, and we've passed. Great, let's read from a second worksheet. We will just simply copy the existing code, which is that great one-liner code, and pass one additional argument name, that being the sheet name. Let's run it. Pass. Done. That's it. Finally, let's read from a password protected file. I'll admit, this is somewhat of a hack, because Excel Mapper does not support reading an encrypted file. It's an error. So we will need to, yes, install the infamous excel.interop-office package. Ugh, I know, but stick with me here. Let's first create a simple using statement here so we can more easily refer to the Excel interop object. Okay, now for the hack. We will open the encrypted workbook, then we will save it as a new workbook with no password, and finally we'll read it. To open it, we'll use the Microsoft Excel Interop library, Excel application. Ugh, I hate this library. Can you tell? W file, workbooks, open, pass it a file name, password, the password that we know that we've got. And finally, we'll save it as a new one, and importantly, pass the new file name. I'll call it underscore no password. Whoop, I forgot something there. Password needs to be null. And importantly, workbook.close, otherwise it's locked. And then we can finally read that new unprotected file. We know that. Nice and easy. We'll pass the file name. If I get this right. And that is it. Let's run it. Failed as expected. Let's change it to 100. Run it again. We're good.